Rockets of the future might look like rockets of the past, but they could also be super sleek, amazing, futuristic single-stage jet planes, you know? Depends. Hey, fabulous flyers. Trace here for DNews. Rockets are essentially the same today as they were in the 1960s. They use better computers, lighter materials, more advanced fuels, but they're still burning massive amounts of chemical fuel to get a payload into orbit or further. But all that aside, what would a rocket of the future look like? Well, kind of like planes and missiles of today. By their nature, it's the job of a rocket to generate enough thrust to leave Earth's orbit. The escape velocity is upwards of 25,000 miles an hour. That requires a lot of fuel for missile-like systems and somewhat less fuel for space planes, but it sort of depends on the job that they need to do. For example, NASA wants to go to asteroids and Mars. They went to the moon with a Saturn V rocket, so they copy and improve on that. Enter the SLS, or Space Launch System. NASA took what they learned from Saturn launches and from the space shuttle as well, and then built on them. The design isn't super sexy because it is built on these proven, read old, technologies. The solid rocket boosters are improved versions of those from the shuttle program, same fuel, almost twice as tall, but basically the same. And the main stage is powered by RS-25 engines, also the same as used on the shuttle program. They're doing this because they know it works, and if it works as planned, it will have more thrust than the Saturn V and will one day send humans to our neighbor planet. But not everyone needs to go to Mars. So some companies are using airplane technology to get high enough into the air and then switching to a rocket engine, so they can enter space and drop off a satellite or maybe humans. Jet engines, though, need oxygen to combust fuel and generate thrust. Space doesn't work that way. So a British company called Reaction Engines Limited has been working on a space plane hybrid for more than 30 years called Skylon that works both in and out of the atmosphere. They created these synergetic air-breathing rocket engines, Sabre, to burn oxygen in the atmosphere when available, mixing it with onboard liquid hydrogen to go 5 times the speed of sound. It's fast. Once it's too high to use the available oxygen, the Skylon uses the same engines but adds onboard liquid oxygen, mixing that with the hydrogen. It's crazy, but they've successfully tested the engines and they hope to fly soon. Ideally, those little wings will let the craft land and be reusable because rockets are really expensive. With the rise of profit-based commercial space companies, you can guarantee that future rockets will be reusable. But another company, Airbus, doesn't want to save the whole rocket like Skylon, just the important parts, the avionics, main engines, and computers. Their Adeline system sits at the bottom of the ESA Ariane 6 rocket stack, holding all of those things inside of it. When the rocket gets the payload safely into orbit, it then heads back to Earth using its little wings to glide safely to a runway for reuse, assuming, of course, they can build it at full size. Until some new technologies come along and make the fuel more combustible or we find another way to get into space, future rockets will look a lot like the tech we have now, only a little bit better. And the rockets of the future are going to have to be more specialized. Some, like the SLS, can lift humans so they can go on to Mars. Others will just pop little satellites into orbit and duck back to Earth. And still others may do jobs we haven't even thought of yet. There may be another way to get to space in the future, though, a space elevator. Get in on the literal ground floor and then ride a cable all the way to space. Check out how that might work along with some other transportation futures in this old video. A space elevator is simply a 22,000-mile cable with a 900-ton elevator crawling up and down it. Real simple. Some plans call for a platform floating in the Pacific around the equator, and the other platform is in space. Do you have a favorite rocket? Why? I mean, I love the space shuttle. I went to space camp. I'm a big nerd about it, and I went back in the 90s. It was like a dream. Tell me about yours down in the comments. Make sure you keep coming back here every day for more DNews, and please take a second and subscribe.